So how many possible situations are there? Well, I could certainly count them this way. I could say that, well, there's three possibilities that I could fill in for north: empty, can, and wall. Robby could find himself in an empty, with an empty square to the north, with a square that has a can in it, or with a wall. So those are the three possibilities for north. And south has the same three possibilities, and so on. And so I could multiply those together, 3 times 3 times 3, 5 times for the four directions and the current site, to get 243. Well, of course, some of those situations could never occur in the world. Wall, 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 all of them being walls. Well, that's just impossible the way we've set up our world. But for the purposes of the genetic algorithm, I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to list all of those possibilities, even ones that aren't real possibilities. So we're going to have a total of 243 possible situations where some of them actually aren't really possibilities, but that's okay, as you'll see. And a strategy would be a listing of all of those possibilities along with the action that Robby should take in each of those possible situations. So here's an example of a strategy. Here I'm not going to list all 243 situations, but I could have the computer do that systematically. And I filled in a random action that I've chosen randomly for each of those situations. Okay, so if we look back at our first picture, we see that Robby finds himself in this situation. Wall to the north, empty, south, can to the east. Wall to the west, empty current site. And I filled in move west. So if Robby found himself in this situation and was obeying this strategy, he would move west and crash into a wall. So I didn't say that this was a good strategy, but it is a strategy. It just happens to be a very bad strategy. And now I can ask a question. What will Robby's score be after following this strategy for 3 time steps? We saw at time step 1, he crashed into a wall. Well, in this world, he bounces back into the same site he was before, and he finds himself in exactly the same situation. Rather stupidly, I admit, given that he's in the same situation, he has to take this action again. So he would crash into a wall again. And likewise, on the 3rd time step, he'd crash into the wall again. He would never learn not to crash into the wall. Well, that's kind of stupid, but his score would be a -5 for every time he crashed into the wall. So he would get a -15 after 3 time steps. So what we want the genetic algorithm to do is to use evolution to weed out these kinds of really stupid strategies and to find the good strategies. Before I show you how the genetic algorithm works, let's do one more quiz. Here's our quiz. We have a strategy for Robby showing only 2 relevant situations. Robby starts here in this position, and the quiz asks, what's Robby's score after performing 2 actions according to this above strategy? So what you have to do is find the situation in the list of situations that corresponds to Robby's current situation, do the action that's associated with that situation, and then look for the new situation in the list, do the move that's associated with that situation, and give what his resulting score would be.